Hello students, today we will solve a problem on design of helical gears. I am reading the problem. A helical cast steel gear with 30 degree helix angle has to transmit 35 kilowatt at 1500 rpm. If the gear has 24 teeth, determine the necessary module, pitch diameter and face width for 20 degree full depth teeth. The static stress for cast steel may be taken as 56 MPa. The face width may be taken as 3 times the normal pitch. What would be the end thrust on the gear? The tooth factor for 20 degree full depth involute gear may be taken as 0.154 minus 0.912 upon TE, where TE represents the equivalent number of teeth. Given velocity factor equal to 15 upon 15 plus V. Now we will solve this problem. First, we will write down the parameters that are given to us in the question. Alpha, helix angle is 30 degree. P, power transmitted by the gear, 35 kilowatt, which is equal to 35 into 10 raised to the power 3 watt. N is RPM of the gear, 1500 RPM. TG, number of teeth on the gear, given as 24. Phi is pressure angle, 20 degree. Sigma naught given as 56 MPa, which is equal to 56 into 10, 56 Newton per mm square. Sigma naught is the static stress for gear material, which is cast steel in this case. We will first calculate torque transmitted by the gear. It can be calculated by the equation T equal to P into 60 by 2 pi n. P is the power, n is the RPM. These values are known to us. We will put this value in the equation. P equal to 35 into 10 raised to the power 3 and n RPM equal to 1500. We will get the value of torque equal to 223 Newton meter, which is equal to 223 into 10 raised to the power 3 Newton mm. Now we will calculate formative or equivalent number of teeth. We know the equation TE equal to TG upon cos cube alpha. TE is the equivalent number of teeth. We will put the value of TG 24 and alpha 30 degree, and we will get TE equal to 37. Now we will calculate tooth form factor. The equation is given in the question itself. Y dash equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 upon TE. If the equation of tooth form factor is not given in the question, then you have to consult the design data book. In this equation, we will put the value of TE equal to 37 and we get Y dash equal to 0.129. Next, we will calculate tangential tooth load. WT equal to T upon DG by 2. WT is tangential tooth load, T is the torque, and DG is pitch circle diameter of gear. DG can be written as M into TG because we know module is pitch circle diameter upon number of teeth. We will put the value of torque and TG. Torque is 223 into 10 raised to the power 3 and TG is 24. After calculating, we will get the value of tangential tooth load in terms of module. WT equal to 18600 by M Newton. Now we will calculate peripheral velocity V equal to pi dg n by 60. We will replace dg by m into tg. Tg is 24, n is the rpm 1500. We will get peripheral velocity in terms of module. V equal to 1885 times m. It is in meter per second. Since we calculate the value of module in mm, so we convert the value of peripheral velocity in mm. V equal to 1.885 m in millimeter per second. Now we will calculate velocity factor. It is given in equation CV equal to 15 upon 15 plus V, which is equal to 15 upon 15 plus 1.885 m. Now we will apply Lewis equation. WT equal to sigma naught into CV multiplied by B multiplied by pi m into Y dash. So we know that face width is 3 times the normal pitch, therefore WT is equal to sigma naught into CV 3 times PN, which is the normal pitch, multiplied by pi m multiplied by Y dash. Now PN here it is replaced by PC cos alpha. You can see PC is the circular pitch and PC is further replaced by pi into m. This we have already studied that PC is equal to pi m. So we will get the final equation of WT equal to sigma naught CV into 3 into pi m cos alpha into pi m into Y dash. Now we will put the values. WT will be replaced by 18600 by m into sigma naught is 56 multiplied by CV, which is 15 upon 15 plus 1.885 m multiplied by 3 into pi m multiplied by cos 30 degree, alpha is replaced by its value, which is 30 degree, multiplied by pi m, multiplied by 0.129. Means y dash here is replaced by its value, which is 0.129. After solving, we will get right hand side equal to 2780 m square upon 15 plus 1.885 m. m is the module. Here we will get a cubic equation in m. Kindly note down a correction. The equation is 279000 plus 35061 m equal to 2780 m cube. Students, please note down this correction. In right hand side, it is not m square, it's m cube. So when you will solve this cubic equation, you can use any hit and trial method, or this equation can be directly solved using your calculator. You will get module equal to 5.5. and we take it as 6 mm. Now we will calculate pitch circle diameter of gear DG. DG is given by module multiplied by number of teeth on the gear TG. So we will get DG equal to 144 mm. So we have calculated module and pitch circle diameter. Now we will calculate the face width and end thrust on the gear. Face width, as mentioned in the question, is it is 3 times the normal pitch, therefore B equal to 3 PN, which is equal to 3 PC cos alpha. PN is replaced by PC cos alpha. Next, PC is replaced by pi into module. So we get B equal to 3 into pi m into cos alpha. So we get B equal to 3 into pi into 6 cos 30 degree, because module is 6 and alpha helix angle is 30 degree. We get the value of face width 48.98 mm and we take it as 50 mm. Now we will calculate end thrust on the gear as asked in the question. And we know that axial load on the gear is called the end thrust. It is given by Wn equal to Wt tan alpha. Wt is 18600 by m, and tan alpha is 30 degree. We will put the value of m equal to 6, and we will get the value of Wn equal to 1790 newton. This is our required answer. I hope you have understood this problem. Go through it once again. All the best.